Hi, I'm John Papa.
And I'm Brian Clark.
And we're going to learn five things about bots. Thing number one, what the heck is a bot?
Well, a bot is something that can help you automate any type of test. So as an example of that, you can think of chat type solutions. So instead of me having this conversation with you, I can use a bot to take my place.
So I could talk into this kind of application, it could translate maybe and then do some action based on what I say?
Yeah, exactly.
That's pretty cool. Number two, what might someone do with a bot?
There's a lot of options actually out there. So you can do something like filling out a form, so make that more automated and simple for somebody to do through natural language. You can do things like connect IoT devices with bots so that you can control them from various different ways, stuff like that.
Cool. So could we hook into things like Alexa and Cortana, Siri, Google?
You can, that's one part of it. So that could be one of the mechanisms to take input and then drive the bot to move forward. But you can use other things like send a text message or just on a timer trigger to set things off to get going.
So various types of input, even like text message, like you said, or just a web form or any of these awesome voice command devices that are out there in the market.
Yes.
But they're the front end for the bot.
Right, exactly.
Cameron, can I phone in a friend for this answer?
Number three, what kind of practical examples have you built with bots?
Well, I've used it to do some home automation. So
very
I've been
cool.
doing a lot of live streaming, doing code on a stream in front of an audience. And what I wanted to make it more of an immersive experience, engaging with the viewers, I used a bot to help control a light bulb in my office so that when people interact with me in the chat up from that live stream on Twitch, they can control that light bulb.
So the bot's like listening for the users on your stream to do something, and then it controls the light, turns it on and off?
Yes, exactly. So they can send in commands through the chat channel, and then that gets sent off to my bot, which will handle that and also integrates with my IoT device, the light bulb that I have.
So your light bulb, what kind of light bulb do you use?
I'm using the LIFX bulb. Because the API for that was just very easy to use and get started, and they have a way of connecting to that over the cloud, so made it a little bit easier, and that way we can get up and running and people can have fun and see the lights flashing around in my office.
So if you tell everybody right now what the command is to turn your lights on or off, will it work if they just like tweet it or something?
No, I turned that off.
Okay.
It's only when I'm live.
Darn it.
Yeah, sorry man.
You disappoint me.
But what's interesting is people from across the globe, like so somebody in Chicago the other day was controlling the light and changing it to go from like red to blue, we call it cop mode, and then I start dancing around like a fool. What? What's wrong with that?
That's just awesome.
That's how you dance.
Yes. Come on, let's dance. Number four, what kind of things can we communicate with bots?
Well, so in my example, I'm communicating with, sending from the bot the message that was received through the chat to Lewis, Lewis AI, which is Azure Language Understanding Service. But you can also connect to things like Skype as an input option, Twitter, Twilio even is another connection.
For text messages?
For text messages. It's a lot of different options that you have there to build any type of bot that you would like to accomplish something.
And the bots can also talk with things like serverless functions and other kind of code that we can interact with?
Yeah, it's crazy the amount of stuff that you can just start pulling and connecting the dots together to make some crazy, system.
It sounds like glue, really, that you can put between all sorts of different technology.
Yes, definitely.
All right, very cool. Number five, if I want to get into this, there's a lot of different technology we talked about. Where might I learn more about it?
Take a wild guess. The best place to get started is at Microsoft Docs, and we'll share some of the links in the video here, but that'll get you started, introduction to what bots are, the bot service that's available, and how you can start coding against that.
And definitely check out Brian's GitHub page as well. He's got some great demos up there on how to get moving with it.
Absolutely, yeah.
Hey, Brian, thanks for coming.
Thank you, sir. You're so kind.
Yes, I am. My name's John Papa.
And I'm Brian Clark.
Dude.
I just went blank. I was thinking, I got him to laugh for once. And I was like so caught up in that moment. I'm Brian Clark.
And I'm John Papa, and we just learned five things about bots.